Enjoy.
Are you ready to go shopping? Step inside a very special supermarket. The only supermarket in the world that gives you money. £2,000 is waiting on our shelves to be won by some lucky person in this store. The aim of the game is to shop smarter and faster than the next person. And everything in this supermarket is up for grabs. Go on, fill your trolleys as high as you can, because shopping has never been so much fun. Yes, there's prizes in store and much, much more when you play Dale's Supermarket Sweep. So, let's welcome today's shoppers, who are Sophie Pingu and Lucy Nimbleby from Leicestershire and Hertfordshire. Valerie Hunter and Alex Drummond from Edinburgh. And Diane Walker and Andrea Downs from Lincolnshire. You're all on Dale's Supermarket Sweep. And here's the star of the show, Dale Winter!
Hello, hi there, welcome, welcome to Supermarket Sweep. Hello, gorgeous trolley dashers!
Hello!
They're happy, they're smiling, you know why? Because they're here today shopping for £2,000! Oh, it's so easy. I'll help you as much as I can. What our shoppers have to do is build up time on their clocks, minutes and seconds, because the more time they have, the more shopping they get to do a bit later on. Now, you see, because time is the main thing here, I'm going to start you all off with a minute each. And here's where I'd like to give you 10 seconds, maybe £25 for your subtotal. It's the mini sweep. Tell me what I'm talking about. Here we go. Without this sauce, their chips taste dry. Alec.
Tomato sauce, Dale.
Tomato ketchup's right. Well done. Alec, I've just given you 10 seconds. Valerie, somewhere out there in the big beyond that I call my supermarket is a bottle of tomato ketchup, the one you need to bring me back for the 25 quid. It's got one of these on, the sweet logo. If you do it within 30 seconds, I promise you that cash will go on your subtotal. Are you ready?
Ready.
Go on, off you go.
Go, Valerie!
Go! Go on, Val!
What is it? What is it? Maybe.
Yes! Yes! I'm so glad you did the run, not Alec. You've no idea. You've no idea. Oh, you're a sporty girl, you are. Well, you got me the 25 quid, you got me the ketchup. Well done. Go and join Alec, I'll be over myself. Lucy and Sophie, welcome to Sweep.
Hi, Dale.
Good, and your cousins.
That's right, yeah.
So you're close as a family then, obviously, yeah. Aren't you, really? Hobbies and interests, this is Sophie. Travel, sports and TV. Do you just like everything on TV, or are you...?
Mainly. Soaps. Oh. More than anything.
Do you have a particular favourite?
Emmerdale.
Where are you from? Hertfordshire and Leicestershire. So are you Leicestershire?
I'm Leicestershire.
So you're getting towards the Yorkshire area, aren't you, anyway? It's become very racy, hasn't it, Emmerdale?
It has, I know.
And you're a bit of a sporty girl, aren't you, Lucy?
Oh, yes.
Jet skiing, water skiing, swimming, and you support Leicester City and Tottenham Hotspur.
That's right, yes. I started off living in Leicester, you see. That's where I was born and where I went to school. And then I moved down to Hertfordshire, and my boyfriend supports Tottenham, so... they're my second team.
Went to see Fatal Attraction in the cinema. When a scary part happened, Lucy jumped and threw most of her popcorn over her shoulder on the people behind her. She made Sophie jump, who spit her Coca-Cola on the rude people next to her. Fortunately, everyone saw the funny side. They didn't mind.
Oh, yes, luckily. It was embarrassing,
yeah,
wasn't it?
They didn't look too pleased at first, but they did see the funny side.
It's a scary movie,
Well,
isn't it?
Well, it was a bit.
I wish you both lots of luck on the sweep. You're very welcome. Lucy and Sophie! Welcome, Valerie and Alec. You're good friends. And it's Valerie that works at the National Gallery of Scotland. And you've got a nickname, haven't you?
I'm called Valerie from the Gallery, unfortunately, dear.
Valerie from the Gallery.
I get letters sent to me out with that, and they actually arrive. Valerie at the Gallery.
That's what they put, and it gets there.
It does.
Fantastic.
I'm
sure
it does.
It says here, now this is interesting, because you've obviously both been asked to say something about each other. And I'll tell you what Valerie said about Alec. Never buys around and gets moody. And when he's bad, Valerie has to give him a good spanking. And she said about him, she never buys around, and pays for the taxis, buys cigarettes, and leaves or leaves Alex's house. So are you mean with each other then?
Oh, yeah, it's incredibly. Mm-hmm.
So when you go to a pub, who does buy the first drink?
Somebody else.
You're joking.
We never go out together. We always take somebody with us.
With a wallet?
Yes, big wallet.
Unbelievable. I mean, if you are a bit like that, it's so nice that you know you're like that. It's not the worst not knowing you're like that.
Of course, well, everybody knows it now. This has kind of spoiled it for us.
No. But, I mean, so it's true what they say about the Scots,
then. Oh, yes.
It is true. The night Valerie was off to a concert, she let some friends do her makeup. She felt great. However, when the lights dimmed down, she began to receive the strangest looks from people. Why was that, Valerie?
My friends had put foundation on and put luminous foundation all over my face. When the lights went down, my face started to glow. Oh,
it glowed in the dark.
And everyone was looking at me. It was so embarrassing.
Well, I've been out with people that have faces that glow in the dark. I still go out with them. I wish you luck today. Valerie and Alec, welcome to Sweet.
Thank you, Neil.
Andrew and Diane, welcome to Sweep. It's good to see you both from Lincolnshire.
Certainly are.
That's a lovely part of the world. That's absolutely lovely. It says here, Diane, it was you, Diane, is obsessed about calories. I mean, when we say obsessed, do you mean really? You count every single calorie?
No. It's just if there's somebody at work and they say they're on a diet, I say, well, you can't have that because that's higher than that. And I just tell them what they should be eating.
you're obsessed about colours that coordinate when you're wearing your clothes.
Definitely.
What are you wearing today? Let's have a look. Well, black, you can wear anything, black trousers, and the green's very nice, and the shoes are black. You are colour coordinated today, yes, you are. Has she done it right?
She has.
And whose idea was it to be here on the Sweep, Andrea?
Both of us, really. I saw it on the TV and thought we're going to have some fun with Dale.
Well, you can have fun with me whenever you like. Diane and Andrea.
Thank you.
Good. Sophie, Alec and Andrea, I will see you later on for a game. Meanwhile, Diane, Valerie and Lucy step forward. We'll put some time on those clocks. Okay. We're now going to play Dale's Scales. Now, the deal here is if one of you gives me the correct answer, I'll give you 10 seconds. If you all agree on the same correct reply, I will give you a bonus 20. You can have half a minute. And you're going to love this one, Diane. It's called Dale's Scales. And I'm going to ask you which one of the following three has the least amount of calories. So let's see how good you really are at those calories. Look at these three. Is it one, the jelly beans? Is it two, the fruit gums? Is it three, the barley sugar? Please vote, make your choice. One, two, or three. Which one of those has the least amount of calories? You've all voted. Lucy, what do you think?
One, Dale.
One, the jelly beans. And Valerie?
Two, Dale.
Two, that's the fruit gums. And Diane?
Three, Dale.
OK, let me do the calories for you. The jelly beans come in at 339. The fruit gums at 296. The barley sugar actually is 321, so two is the right answer. Well done, Valerie. You've added 10 seconds. You're back in competition with each other. Here's where I test your powers of observation. Bobby's going to show you all manner of what have you at the checkout. Try and remember as much as you can from what you're about to see. Questions will be asked afterwards. So, Bobby, what have you got for us today?
Our first item is chicken and ham paste. A packet of prawn crackers. Orange flavoured jelly. A tin of Marifat processed peas. And a packet of penne rigate.
Thank you very much, Bobby. Here are your questions. Which item was flavoured with seafood? Which item was flavoured with seafood? Let me know. Buzz in as soon as you can. And, or straight away, Lucy.
The pasta dale.
It's not the right answer. Do you want to play Valerie and Diane? Valerie.
The chicken hand spit. Chicken and hand spread.
It's not the right answer. Diane, let me know.
Prawn crackers.
Prawn crackers. Seafood. Girls, I wonder if you could tell me, which meats did the paste contain? And Lucy?
Chicken and ham, Dale.
It's the right answer, well done. There were a special type of peas there. What were they? And Lucy?
Marrowfat processed peas.
Absolutely, marrowfat will do nicely. And finally, what kind of pasta did we see? Lucy?
Pen
is
pasta
right.
Dale.
Absolutely right. Well done, 10 seconds. I'd say it was a good time to bring back your partners. Welcome back, shoppers. At the moment, it's looking good. Not much separating you. 110, 120 and 130. Lucy, Valerie and Diane, I shall see you later on for the round robin. For now, thank you. Returning players, step forward. We're going to have a game. It's a pricing game. Now, the good deal here is if you play this one right, you can all have 10 seconds of throw on each part of the game. You can make 30 seconds as we play higher or lower. Have a look what I bring you off the shelves today. Now, I will tell you, I will sell you the chocolate chip cookies for 99 pence. Now, I've told you what I'm going to charge you for those, but consider the pack of shortcakes. Would they be higher or lower in price than the cookies? Please vote higher or lower. All three of you have gone lower. I wonder, lower than 99 pence? I'd say you've all added 10 seconds. Good. Now then, the shortcakes are 67 pence. What do you reckon to the rich tea biscuits? Would they be higher or lower in price? Again, please vote. And you've all gone lower again? Lower than 67 pence? Yeah, 53 pence, another 10 seconds. And finally, a pack of simple digestive biscuits. Would they be higher or lower in price than the rich tea? Please vote, make your choice. All three have gone higher. Higher than 53? Not in my supermarket, 36. So no time added to your clocks there, but you've all added 20 seconds. Well done. We're now going to play word search. You know those word games you see in the back of magazines and newspapers where you find certain answers you're looking for jumbled up amongst all the other words? With the help of an initial clue, I need you to tell me what the word is I'm looking for and let me know whether it appears across, diagonal or down. OK? There's your grid. Here's your first clue. Your clue is, this dark sugary syrup is used to make treacle. Popular in America, Andrea?
Crossdale molasses.
It's the right answer, molasses. This one's a salted fish named after a duck. Sophie?
Shark.
It's not the right answer. And I was going to say it begins with the letter B. Alec?
Bombay Dale.
Bombay, that's right, well done. Where is it? Across.
Across.
Absolutely right, well done. Make a chain of this small flower. Andrea?
Daisy Dale, and it's down.
Absolutely right, well done. Interesting clocks, I'll tell you how well you're doing in a moment. First, let's bring back the other shoppers. This is shaping up to be a good supermarket sweep because, believe it or not, you all have 1 minute and 50 seconds. Very close. However, here's your last chance to add time to those clocks. What you put on them now is what you'll go shopping with out there into the supermarket, so I wish you luck. It's the round robin. That means you take it in turns to hopefully give me a correct answer, and then everybody changes. So, returning players, step forward, you're going to go first. And all questions are about music. Sort of questions I've got from looking at the CDs and cassettes over there in the corner of the store. Here we go. Which 70s band wanted a man after midnight? Valerie.
ABBA.
They did. Change. The Beatles sang about his Lonely Hearts Club Band. Alex.
Sergeant Pepper did.
Is the right answer. Change. The Bee Gees sang about which American state? Valerie.
Massachusetts state.
Is right. Change. Which 70s group sang about Rasputin and also had a hit, Alec?
Boney M, Dale.
Boney M's, right. Well done, change. He said that John, I'm only dancing, and sang of Life on Mars. Valerie?
David Bowie.
You're good at this round, change. Whose papa had a brand new bag? Sophie?
Don't know.
He also said that it's a man's world and like living in America. And he's a soul singer and a legend. And his surname is a colour. Alec buzzed as the buzzer went. What do you reckon? Who would you have said?
Brown, somebody Brown. I can't remember.
Yeah, James Brown would have been the right answer, but it doesn't matter. You've done well enough already. Look at that. I can now tell you just how much time you have to go shopping. Lucy and Sophie, you have 1 minute and 50. Diane and Andrea, you also have 1 minute and 50. And with 2 minutes and 40, Valerie and Alec. OK. You're just seconds away from going wild in the aisles. I wish you luck. What I need you to tell me is which member of each team is going to be running the sweep. Lucy, Alec and Andrea, good luck. Come back in a few moments. They're going to go off their trolleys, hopefully leaving here today with the £2,000. Where else? It's Supermarket Sweep.
Your dry dog food pack can be very revealing. Look at the list of ingredients. The main ingredient is often wheat or chicken meal. But the number one ingredient in new principle is chicken. fresh chicken, and even more fresh chicken makes Principle the dry dog food with the most fresh chicken you can buy. New Principle, the number one ingredient is fresh chicken. Your dog will love it.
Colour is your passion, but from the first wash, traditional shampoos can begin to fade your colour to leave it looking lifeless. Organics invents Colour Active, the first ever mousse shampoo created to keep your colour fresh. This luxurious mousse formulation gently cleans and conditions, keeping your colour rich and vibrant. Even after 20 shampoos, Organics Colour Active preserves up to 93% of your colour intensity. Organics Colour Active keeps colour fresh. New Refresh from Comfort captures smells and neutralizes them, leaving clothes with a just washed fragrance. New Refresh from Comfort.
Every day, Claims Direct is working for thousands of people. People who've had accidents, people just like you. So, if you've been injured as the result of an accident, then call Claims Direct now, because you could be entitled to compensation. Claims Direct is one of the UK's leading personal injury specialists, with over 300 claims managers dedicated to helping the victims of accidents. If you've suffered an injury at work as the driver or passenger in a car accident or a trip or fall anywhere, then call Claims Direct now. We've helped thousands of accident victims, people like Carrie Gillis.
After seeing their ad on telly, I made one phone call, they took it from there, and I received over £5,000.
Remember, we can underwrite the total cost of making your claim. If we're not successful, you don't pay us a penny. So don't delay. If you've been injured, call Claims Direct now to find out if you could be entitled to compensation. Phone Claims Direct free on 0800 448895. Call now.
Two little boys had two little toys. Each had a wooden horse. Gaily they played.
Honey Nut Shredded Wheat. The honey and nuts on shredded wheat bites make them so delicious.
One little chap then had a mishap.
You just won't want to share them. Honey Nut Shredded Wheat. Too moorish to share.
Welcome back to Supermarket Suite. Our teams did brilliantly before the break, building up time on their clocks. Here's the time they have to go shopping. Pink team to go first as usual. Valerie and Alec, you have 2 minutes and 40. Followed by our blue team, Sophie and Lucy, with 1 minute and 50. And our yellow team, strange enough, with the same amount of time, 1 minute 50. Have a look round. You're going to load those trolleys high and wide, and that's a supermarket you're going to do it in. I do wish you luck. If you can remember to grab an inflatable bonus if you see one, do so. They're worth between £25 and £100. And I'm only allowing you one to a shopper, please. Also, over there in the corner, Mel's there. Right, Dale's display. If you manage to stack all your own team colour tins pyramid style, I'll put £50 on your subtotal. Also, Phil's over there with the pricing guns. There's one for each of you. That's also worth 50 quid a person, if you get it right. And I've also got a shopping list. This is worth £100, but I need one of each of these items. And on my shopping list today, an onion, some fresh orange and cranberry drink, and a writing pad. If you bring me back one of each of those items, 100 quid straight away on your subtotal. One question. Are you ready to go shopping?
Yes, Dale!
I'm so glad to hear it. Get ready, Valerie and Alec. I'm going to count you in. 3, 2, 1, go!
There we go. It's Alec who's out on his own this morning. And he abandons the trolley because he knows his onions. Yes, that's the onion on Dale's shopping list. And now he pulls the trolley up to the pricing gun and hopefully the £50 bonus up there as he prices the tins. He knows his stuff and he gets the tins nicely in the basket. No, you might be better pushing that, Alec, rather than pulling it. But it's a big bouncy bonus for him as well. And he's smiling. It looks as though all the way back to the checkout. And why shouldn't he? He's doing some smart shopping from Alec. No, don't even think about it. Now, He races down towards Armel this time at Dale's display, and he's going to make up the pyramid of tins worth another £50 bonus. So it's a cracking start for him. And back at the start, finally, it's Lucy that gets into the marketplace for the blue team and picks up a box of chocolates. At the top of the tins is Alec, and he's away back into the marketplace. Andrea there raced onto the scene with a big bouncy banana bonus. And there's Lucy pricing up the tins. Come on, Lucy. Come on, Lucy. That's it. Now, the tins, they go on top of one another, Andrea. Come on, Andrea. That's it. Come on, you're nearly there. The peak of condition. Look at that. And a £50 bonus as well. And Alex got a new trolley already, and he's in amongst the tins of a different kind down there. This is Lucy. He picks up the onion. That's on Dale's shopping list. And she gets it back to the trolley. Now, watch Andrea do it. She's looking a bit confused. Come on, Andrea. You've got a bit of time to make up there. Now, here's Lucy looking for the orange and cranberry juice on Dale's shopping list. Alec thinks he's got it as well, but we're looking for the fresh. That's not the one. Now then, there's Andrea. Bless her. It's a champagne moment for Lucy. And we go around the corner. That banana's going to give us a bit of trouble, Andrea. It was a bar of chocolate there for Alec, and now he goes for the shampoo. He's still smiling. We've got a bit of trouble with the banana. And here goes Lucy racing down towards the tins. She's going to tamper with the tins to the top for a £50 bonus. But the seconds are ticking away now. We're in the Chinese section. A spot of rice, I think, for Alec this time. And it's the top of the tins with Lucy. It's nappies on the top of the trolley there for Andrea. She's got to get that back to the checkout. And now it's Alec who races down towards the ready meals. Come on, Alec. Here's Andrea with an empty trolley. Why is it empty, Andrea? For goodness sake, put something in your trolley. It's nappies for Lucy. Now, come on, Andrea. What are you doing? You're looking for the orange and cranberry juice. That's it. Well done. It's back to Dale.
Thank you, Bobby, for guiding us through that tweet. Come on back, shoppers. Come on back. We're going to let Claire, Caroline and Resi run all these items through the till to find out who's going to go for the super sweep. So let's check them out.
And here's a chance for you to win £250 in today's home viewer game. Here's the item we're looking for with some of the letters missing. And here's your clue. A buttery biscuit that's not so long. And don't forget, it's already been featured in today's pricing game. And that clue again? A buttery biscuit that's not so long. So if you think you know the answer, then give us a call on 090-11-334-334. That's 090-11-334-334. So go on, give us a call.
Thank you, Bobby. Yes, one lucky caller picked at random will win £250 on the day. And there are five runner-up prizes of those wonderful supermarket sweep rucksacks. And whether you get the answer right or wrong, you're still going to our grand prize draw. And at the end of the series, you can win £5,000. So be lucky, give us a call. Let's do those shopping totals. Diane and Andrea, well, it's looking good. What's your bonus worth, Andrea?
£25,
£25, good. What have you got there, Diane? Oh, Dale's display.
That's Dale's display.
That's right, good. That's another £50. Gives you a subtotal of £75. I'll add that to the value of the goods in your trolley. Gives you a grand total on supermarket sweep today of 151. That's good.
That's very good.
Sophie and Lucy, let's have a look. What's your champagne worth there, Sophie?
£50, Dale.
That's good. Lucy, what a good look this is. You've got the Dale's display and the pricing on item.
We have, yes.
50 and 50. Add the other 50, a subtotal of 150. Which, when added to the value of the goods in your trolley, gives you a grand total on sweep today of £211. Well shot. Valerie and Alec, well, you got the mini sweep earlier. I'll give you £25 for that. Alec, what's your bonus worth, your hamburger? Is it going to be a good one? 100.
100.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Pop it behind you, Alec. Go on, pop it on the counter. You've also got, you've got the pricing gun items and Dale's display. 50, 50, added to the 100 and the 25. Gives you a subtotal of 225. You know what that means? What that means is you're going to go through to the super sweep. But I will tell you, though, when you add that together with the value of the goods in your trolley, it gives you a grand total today of £332. Well shot. Thank you, Lucy, Diane and Andrea. Thanks for being great shoppers. Right. Okay. Where are you going? Come and have a look at the supermarket. Stand next to that lovely lady here. Now have a look. Now, somewhere out there in the supermarket, there is £2,000 hidden in cash. You're going home with the money, aren't you?
Yes, they are.
I know you can do it. The way it works is you have a minute to find the cash and keep it. What you need to do is solve the clues that lead you to the three specially marked products. Your money's behind the third item. That minute won't even begin till I've read you this card, which is your first clue. So don't panic when you hear the first bit. We'll help you as much as we can. Are you ready?
Yep, ready.
Going over the £2,000?
Yes.
I hope so too. The kids are bored and screaming and kicking, so keep them quiet with four burgers of...
Chicken burgers.
Chicken burgers, right. Go, 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 go.
Avoid the preparation. Avoiding the preparation is what this means when you buy some frozen, not fresh.
Green beans.
Probably. Maybe. Look at it again. Frozen, not fresh.
Oh, come on back. Come on back, shoppers. Did you get the green beans?
No, we didn't.
They're in there. I think you packed, but they're actually in the freezer, in the right place, exactly.
Just
I think
spent
they... Oh, dear, oh, dear. Have you had a good day today?
Lovely
day.
Lovely.
You've been
thank
wonderful
you.
Shoppers. I'm sorry not going home with the £2,000. But I'll send you home with the value of the goods in your trolley, which is something, I guess.
Thank you.
That takes care of another day on Supermarket Sweep. And remember, the next time you're at the checkout and you hear the beep, think of the fun you could be having on Supermarket Sweep. Have a good day.
Yes, indeed, think of the fun. And we compile those trolleys sky high yet again, gang, tomorrow afternoon at 20 to 3. But back to this afternoon for the very latest ITV News headlines and our regional bulletins here with us next.